How might we use Python to access data in the real world? For example, if we've got data in a file, how do we use that? So let's look at the problem. We've got some words and a translation in a text file. So how do we get that into Python and use it? Well, a good way to start would be to search online. Type in Python and what the problem is with some keywords. And you'll probably get the answer through something like Stack Overflow. So here's an example. We've got Python file into dictionary. So it's given us some answers and some web pages we might want to use. So we've had a look, and here's a couple of web pages, including Stack Overflow. If we look inside the code, we can see here a solution on both pages that's almost identical. So let's try this and run the code and then amend the code to our problem. So start off, let's test it. So here we have the text and we've created a file with A1, B2, C3. And if we run this, we can see we have a dictionary of 1A, 2B and 3C. Let's change and test it. So we need to change this code to meet our requirements. So we can start off with some small changes. So we have the same data but separated by commas. So if we change our code, let's see what happens. Now we have 1A, 2B and 3C, but you'll see this slash n, which means the new line is still there. So we need to strip the line. And let's see if that works. So now we have 1A, 2B, 3C. So that works. Here we've got a text file with English and Chinese. So let's test this. So we need to change our code. First of all, we need to get the correct file. We also need to change the encoding because we're using a different language. And finally, we're not using an integer, so we need to change that. So now we have the same code. We've just added the encoding, changed the file name, and taken out the key being changed to a number. So let's try this. So that worked. Here we have the three words and the Chinese. So let's try a different language. Here we have another file called dictionary. And this has English and Thai. So let's try this. And that worked as well. There are some strange characters at the beginning, but apart from that, it did seem to work. So that's good. So far, so good. But there's always problems. So let's try it with some test data. So we know it works with the dictionary. Now we have another file called All Dictionary. So let's run this. Now we see here we have this value error, too many values to unpack. And what may have happened here is that we have lines that have a key but don't have a value. So we need to find a solution to this problem. One way we can get around this problem is creating a list. So that will take in however many values are split by the comma. So now we want to change our code so our dictionary takes the first part of the list, the first item in the list, and the second item in the list. So now when we run this, we can see that it's worked. There's quite a lot of words in here, but our code has worked. How about some other ways? We can try it with a word. So here we've got April, that's a test. So now we can test a dictionary, and here is the Thai word for April. There are other ways to do this. If we go back to our online search, we can see code that's quite similar, but this uses a function called getPair, and it separates the key as a key separator and value. And when we run that with April, again, we see the same answer. So there's different ways of using a dictionary. What about other data structures? Well, we can change our code to use a list, for example. So here, we've stripped our line. Now, if there's two values, in case it's blank, we've got the first list called words and the second list called translation, trans for short. So the first word is going to go in the words list and the second word is going to go in the trans list. So we've got two lists. Now, when we look for our word and our translation, we find the index. We can use index to find out where that occurs in the words list. And then we can look in the second list at that number to print the word. So when we run this and we look for April, again, we find the correct word. An alternative to using this would be using the tuple. So we have two values in a tuple and we have a list of those tuples. So let's have a look at the code. Again, we're using the same code. Again, we're checking the length is 2 of the list. But what we're going to do is we're going to put the word and the translation in a pair. That's a tuple called pair. And then append that to the words list. So when we get the list, we can go through that list. And if the first element within the item of the list is that word, April, then we can see the second element in that tuple. If we run this, again, we see the correct word for April. But notice this has given us 4 answers. That means in our dictionary, he's actually in there 4 times. So wait a second. If our dictionary has more than one item in there, it's duplicated. And if we use a dictionary, that will be overwritten. If we use a list, an index, we will retrieve the first occurrence of that translation. Now we've used a tuple, it saved each individual pair. So even if it's duplicated, it's there. So does this make a difference? Yes, it does. But how? Let's go back to our original code with a dictionary and now use the word eat. So let's run this. Now, it's given this word, jiao. So this does mean eat, but normally eating ties gin. So that's a bit strange. And we try it with our list. Eat. Again, we've got a correct answer, but this is different. It's gin. So these both mean eat, and we're looking in the same dictionary, but we've got a different answer. So what's occurred? Well, if we use our tuple, this may give us the answer. When we run this, we see gin, gin, and jot. We see the 3 words that are in our dictionary. So in our dictionary there's multiple answers. So even with the code that we've done to look at our problem and find a solution, there are also other issues that we need to look at. So we may need to look at what data structure do you really need. If you've got a dictionary and you're going to use a dictionary data structure, then you can only have a key, has to be unique. Now, if you want to save multiple values, for example, for eat, we have 2 values and we even have a duplicate, then we can use a tuple. We could use a list, but we need additional code because at the moment, if you just use index, you're just going to find the first occurrence. Index just finds the first. So these are issues that we deal with in real life when we're coding. Okay, if you enjoyed that, please click the like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Thank you for watching.